Hello everybody, my name is RagingRaptor and I welcome you to a new World of Tanks video. And today's video will be a little bit different than usual. Then we are looking at some stats and some informations we got so far about the Italian tanks and their new mechanics. And we'll have a look at something as the title suggested, which is, does the Leopard 1 or will the Leopard 1 also get this new mechanic? Because, well, yeah, there was, this is also why I want to do this video, there was a Reddit post some time ago, 6 days ago to be precise, where somebody was freaking out that the Leopard 1 isn't Wargames videos and it has a free shot round Autoloader or Revolver magazine. And that he would be super happy about it if they would actually introduce something like that, because let's be honest, the Leopard 1 is not a really strong tank. And to be fair, I honestly agree with that statement that the Leopard 1 at the moment is a really weak tank. Because let's be honest, if you're in a 3-5-7 game and you're playing against the Object 430U, you're simply like a burden to your team because you simply can't do anything about it. But if you now look closely at the picture of the Reddit post, that certainly looks really strongly like a Leopard 1. And you can see that if we zoom a little bit more inside, that there is actually this free shot autoloader. It's a little bit hard to see if this is actually a Leopard 1. It looks kind of like it, but we are not entirely sure. So one of the comments which was, is you sure that is a Leopard and not a new Italian tank? Because apparently, I believe it's a placeholder, some people say, but also some people say that there is a tier 9 vehicle which looks roughly like the tier, like a Leopard 1. And he is apparently right. This is the tier 9 Italian tank, and you can certainly see that the hull is the one of a Leopard. Without a doubt, that's the hull of a Leopard 1. And the turret, though, certainly doesn't look exactly like what we have here. Now, what is other? Could it be the tier 10 tank? No, that is a tier 10 tank and it certainly does not look like a Leopard 1. So now, what could it else be? Well, if we go back 2 months roughly, Wargaming released a video called New Nation, New Mechanics. And in there they tried to explain what exactly is going to be on in this new mechanic and what is going to happen with certain tanks. And then, well, let's just listen a short episode of what they're saying.
Over the course of the next few days, our Italian will receive its primary settings and depart to close testing.
There are still many tests to be done. We will experiment with timings, we will experiment with their ratios. We will see which option is better and which gameplay type is more suitable.
We are currently at the very first test stage, and these are just preliminary settings. The mechanics have vast potential and are suitable for more than just medium tanks.
We have heavy vehicles too, and we have vehicles that are peculiar in their other in-game characteristics. On the whole, our task is to make a new gun type in the game.
But don't rush to judge a vehicle for its technical characteristics alone. The mechanics are highly complicated, and it would be wrong to judge them by just the numbers. We want to analyze the gaming experience.
Okay, as you probably looked through the little snippet of footage a little bit closer, you probably noticed there was again the same footage as I already showed you in the Reddit post. And another peculiar thing is in that specific snippet of this video, they are actually saying that they want to introduce this mechanic, this whole new gun mechanic, to other tanks and other people, or yeah, other tank classes like heavy tanks. So I guess that is something many people didn't really look into that, because I nowhere saw anybody really pointing that out, I think. But yes, it is actually pretty nifty that people are not pointing this out, and it's like, sorry, it's pretty nifty that actually we are probably going to get a new mechanic, not only for the Italian tanks, but also for other tanks, like Leopard 1. And some people even said that this this mechanic could be even introduced to the Centurion.
Quickly, and the second order ammo rack that could be used for manual stowage of the shells. Thus, we were thinking about how to introduce this into the game. The Italians also had similar automatic loaders, and that is how the new mechanics were added.
As you can see, they're now showing obviously placeholder stats, and they are showing that it is placeholder stats. But that could theoretically be that tanks like the TVP will get a complete overhaul. Tanks like the Centurion would probably get something like such a new mechanic, like this autoloader mechanic. And even heavy tanks. For example, the IS-3A, which is probably one of the most mediocre or even worst non-special matchmaking tier 8 premium heavy tanks. It's just the IS-3 hull with a thicker turret and only 3 crew members and a little bit faster reload, but horrible accuracy. But yes, as you probably saw by now, this could actually, for example, introduce a new mechanic to premium tanks. It could theoretically introduce a new mechanic to the IS-7, because in-game the IS-7 obviously has 2 crew members, which are loaders. IRL, or in real life, this is not the case. IRL, the IS-7 certainly does use an autoloader, or used to have an autoloader, which, as you could think of, would theoretically be perfect for such a new mechanic. So, and the last question, if Wargaming decides to introduce something like that, could it finally change the meta? And this sounds a little bit awkward how I phrased it. I said it finally changes the meta, but right now we are in a meta where like gold spamming and especially highly armored vehicles like 430U, Type 5 Heavy are simply predominant in high tier battles. And this is actually pretty darn annoying, and I honestly hope that with this new mechanic such tanks will go back a little bit and people will try to play more less armored vehicles, like, as we already discussed, the Leopard 1 with such a new mechanic, and probably something like the TVP or Centurion 1 more. It would be really fun and really nice to see that if Wargaming would actually introduce finally again something new. Last time we got a new mechanic was with the Swedish. Yeah, Swedish tanks, nicht die Schweden. And yes, it is actually a pretty cool mechanic in my opinion, the siege mode. It is definitely not for everybody. It's certainly not for everybody. But overall, it is a fun mechanic, and if you get the hang of it, it is actually pretty nice to use, especially now with 1.0, where bushes are stronger than ever. Where you can easily use the 50 meters rule and never get spotted if you play it or more or less correctly. So yeah, what do you guys think? I personally am pretty hyped about that, and apparently on the 12th of April, which would be tomorrow if you watch the video when it is released, we will probably be able to find something like that. We will have the opportunity to play this new Italian tanks. I don't think that Wargaming is going to introduce yet other tanks than the Italian tanks with this new mechanic. They probably want to wait a little bit. We know that they are not the fastest when it comes to balancing stuff. Cough, cough, E5, cough, cough, Object 268 version 4. And yes, I personally really do hope that we will see, maybe with the introduction of the Polish vehicles, maybe something new. And I think we will get more additional information, especially about our Polish vehicles, around Gamescom, which would align perfectly for them to show some stuff up. Again, it is at the moment April, and my suggestion or my theory is that around mid-May to end of May, the Italian tanks will be released onto the live server. So then it would be pretty perfectly for Wargaming to show at the end of August at Gamescom the new Polish tanks and even the new mechanic for other vehicles. Otherwise, if you enjoyed the video, let me know in the comment section below as well. And I thank you so much for your attention. And I'll talk to you all later. And good luck on the battlefield. Bye-bye.